Hi, I'm Professor Brian Kirby. We're here in the Toyota Forklift Learning Studio, where a bunch of students are tearing down and rebuilding this Toyota 15Z.
Inline 6 engine, so there's 6 cylinders.
Today, we got the opportunity, just for fun on a random Friday, to take apart this engine.
Here in the learning studios at Cornell, we want to encourage students to be exposed to specific engineering systems so that they can link those together with the classes that they're taking.
I'm in mechanical synthesis right now, which has been really cool to kind of learn about the mechanical process and how you build a machine.
So some example of the engineering decisions that students need to know about are, what is the engine block? What is it made of? Why is it cast iron?
Why is the cylinder head made out of cast iron? Is that typical of other engines? Would all other engines be made of the same material?
What decisions would you make to pick a 6-cylinder engine, which is what we have here, versus a 4-cylinder engine? How does that relate to the power generated? How does it relate to the vibration and vibration balancing in the system?
Why is there a coolant pump here? And like, what does it connect to?
And again, these things all link back to the classes that the students take in thermodynamics, in heat transfer, fluid mechanics, and dynamics. Go to it.
Oh, yeah,
it's fine.
So I haven't had any other prior experience to this. So actually deconstructing the engine for the first time, it seemed daunting. It was actually fully guided.
The most exciting part of this journey for me has been taking apart the camshaft, because I really got to learn more about kind of the concepts I've learned in some of my classes, like mechanical synthesis.
Firing order of this engine is 1, 5, 3, 6, 2, 4. New nuts, new bolts. Color coded.
I think my favorite part was like the grand reveal of the cylinders.
Ooh! Wow!
And the pistons inside, because I've seen those in my classes. Like, we studied in my fluid and heat transfer lab, we studied the 4-stroke engine, and we took data once and had to like analyze it. So basically, everything that's in my notes is drawn out kind of in here. So once we revealed it, I was like, oh my gosh, I know that. That's in my notes.
So I really liked taking off the cover for the gears, just so we could see how the power was distributed back to the fuel injection pump and the camshaft, and how that really operated, and how everything was kept in sync.
I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 gears. Another thing that comes from doing things in the prescribed order is that when you have 26 bolts to take off, you take off 26 instead of 24.
So...
Oh.
I am full of muscle.
What are we doing next?
We're inserting a finger into the cam followers, just pulling them out. Just pull them out.
Oh my gosh.
This example, this Toyota 15Z engine, embodies many of the things students learn in the mechanical engineering department here. That includes material selection, hydrodynamic bearings and pumps, strength of materials, all of the different things that the students learn in classes. We want them to be able to see how that relates to an actual physical object. By letting these students tear this engine down and then rebuild it, we give them an opportunity to see all of these engineering decisions in action.
It was really enjoyable and kind of learn how all this works and see how it connects to our classes. I had a great time.